Welcome everybody to another edition of Homeopathy with the Help Library. Last time we saw about a few drugs, and today we are going to see about the different children's types. What do you mean by children types? Well, different type of children. I was different when I was a child. You were different. My cousin was different. And Dr. Kavita also was different as a child. But does this really help us to select a medicine? The answer is yes, because the way we elderly people are constitutions, similarly these youngsters also are constitutions. You snatch a toy from a boy and he'll start yelling. But his neighbor, if you snatch a toy, probably he'll go in his house and get another toy and give it to him. This is the difference. So the difference is seen right from the childhood. It is said, Barache pai palnya distat, which means that the nidus formation, the character formation, the nature development, everything happens in the childhood. Hence, all children are different, and homeopathy, we have different personalities to suit different children, and hence different medications to suit different children. How does it help? Does it change their nature? Will a cranky child suddenly become cheerful? Or will a child who is always irritable stop his irritation? Or will a child who is prone to colds and cough suddenly stop cold and cough? The answer is no. But yes, the answer is yes, in the form that it can be useful to modify those tendencies if these tendencies are going beyond a certain norm. You can't stop an attack of cold coming. Children are bound to get something. But yes, with our medications, you can control it to such an extent that it will not be bothering the child and hence the mother. Dr. Rahul Joshi here for you, and my colleague Dr. Kavita Shah Chandaramani, who is going to also discuss the remedies. Kavita, so which remedy you have for us first?
Friends, our first remedy we start with is calcarea carb. I'll take this. Here we see a very chubby, fair, fatty, and a flabby kid. So loving, so adorable. Just feel like going and hugging a calcarea carb baby. On mental grounds, a calcarea carb baby is very sensitive to cruelties, very sensitive to harsh words. Baby will always want to be protected, attached to some family member or some relative. Family persons, as we say. Very inquisitive. You take a child out and you start asking, Mummy, ye kya hai? Papa, wo kya hai? Why this? Why is it raining? For example, just a recent example of Ganpati Visarjan, that a young child asked, ki Ganpati kyun doob gaye? Ganpati ko swimming nahi aata hai? This is typical of calcarea carb. But very hard-working kids, academically they perform excellent and very dedicated. If you see a general view, the guiding symptoms, a calcarea carb baby, of course, has the constitution very fair, fatty, flabby, chubby, sweats profusely, more sweat or more perspiration on the forehead, especially in the night hours, and baby will always desire to eat eggs. Craves for eggs like crazy. Great craving for indigestible things like salt, pika, what we say, chalk, pencil. Tendency to catch cold easily. Any weather change or any dust allergy, these kids have a tendency to catch cold very easily. And a very good remedy for chronic constipation. So this is our superb or a fair, fatty, and a flabby calcarea carb baby sleeping peacefully.
Very adorable, isn't he?
Yes, yes, very much. Do you all agree?
Well, all children are very adorable. But calcarea carb, as Kavita said, fair, fat, and flabby child. I think she mentioned that they are also habit of getting tired. They are very fat. People feel, but maa to bolegi, kitna healthy hai, itna healthy hai, mar fir bhi kamzor kyun hai mera bachcha? The answer is that it is muscle, not the muscle, it is a flab. So the quantity is there, but the quality should be improved with the help of good medications. Then this Sina child. Kavita, were you this way? No, not really. Okay. This is the child who keeps on crying, who keeps on groaning, who keeps on lamenting all the time. This child will always be grumbling. This child has an irritable temperament. He will never be satisfied. Arre kai jhala? Su thayu? Kai jhala? Kai nahi? Highly irritable. Then you go near him or her. What happened? Sandeep, what happened? And he will just throw a fit. We are going to talk about some other child after this who is also similar to this. He wants everything. Mane aa jo hai mala he paije mala ice cream paije, but when you give ice cream or when you give whatever he wants, he will refuse it. Repugnant, peevish, ill-humored. Of course, there are a lot of plus points also. We are just talking about the more highlighting points of this Sina baby, which is marked by irritability, which is marked by a constant peevishness, a fretfulness. They cannot take anything as such. They just cry vehemently all the time. This is one of our very good remedies, our mainstay remedies for worms, grinding of the teeth because of worms, dentition remedy as well, nocturnal edulysis are the characteristic of Sina. Sina is useful even in elderly. Many people come with recurrent worms. I'm just seeing a patient who has got recurrent worms. Even these albendazole and all cannot, you can't keep on repeating it. The tendency of worm formation can be eradicated with our Sina. So this is a cousin of Sina, but Sina is more of the temperament wise, much more irritable. Natriumure is intelligently irritable. I'm not saying Sina is not intelligent, but Natriumure goes in more of the refined drugs. Natriumure also is a very pretty child, unlike the Sina counterpart. Well, all children are pretty, but we are talking here about the fair color vis-a-vis Sina, which is more towards the darker side. Look at the beautiful Natriumure child. The skin of Natriumure is oily and shiny and a bit of greasy. The map tongue, a very hot patient, hot means aggravated by hot, is of paramount importance. The other extraordinary features are, again, the irritation level of Natriumure is immense. The Natriumure child, you ask him questions, will not answer you back. Natriumure child does become a problem child because he wants so many things, keeps on demanding so many things. You go close to him, you touch that baby, try to caress it, and will throw into a fit of anger. Even the Baraita ka, we are going to see ahead, has got anger. But the Baraita anger is more because of certain other reasons, and this Natriumure is more because, why did you touch me? Why did you do this? It's that egotism which is seen right in the childhood. It is that irritation which is seen, that anguish which is seen right in the childhood in this remedy called Natriumure. Natriumure does not want to be touched. Touch me not. Keep safe distance. My colleague Dr. Rashna was also helping me out in this presentation. A beautiful presentation. What you see today is all because not my work, it's Dr. Kavita's work and Rashna's suggestions. Craving for salt. They would like to have extra salt. They would like to have chaat items. You know, they won't ask salt as a, but we have to understand that through what they crave for. The child is weeping almost inconsolably. Any small child, you know, in a train also is weeping, we feel like, why this little child is crying? And this auntie gives me chocolate. Now I'm the Natriumure child. Contradiction, aggravation, consolation, aggravation. Touch me not. The only way to win over these people is leave them alone. Natriumure people are difficult children. Again, not that I have against them. Natriumure are difficult children. What happens to these natrum children is that if you really want them to come along with you for a movie, you tell them, "Arey Rajesh, nako yo ustu aza, don't come for a movie. It's a horror movie. Don't come." And when you tell him, "Don't come," he will come. If you really want him to play cricket with you, you said, don't come. But natrums are, unfortunately, the nature is such that people and the other children don't like to be with them. That's why other children find a technique. If they don't want him to come, they'll say, chal amcha barbar. And then he will not come. Not going. So that's the natrum. Kavita, please throw the light on pulsatilla.
So we see a blue-eyed pulsatilla child. Beautiful looking kids, blue eyes, very fleshy, fine hair and a flawless skin is pulsatilla. Chilly, thermally if you go to see, it's a chilly patient. Cold or any change weather will easily affect a pulsatilla child. And sir, will you agree we can spot a pulsatilla child very quickly, very neatly dressed. They want everything matching. If they are wearing a red top, they want a red rubber band, they want the red shoes. A well-dressed and a well-expressive face is a pulsatilla child. Very mild, very gentle babies, very friendly. You can play with them. They mix very easily. And consolation. Contradicting to a natrum mute child, if you go and you talk to the person or offer a chocolate, offer a sweet, will readily give you a smile. Mixes very easily with people. But yes, we see a changeability of mental conditions. A weeping disposition will change into a laughing disposition. When she's laughing, kid will start crying. This is the changeability of a pulsatilla child. Of course, these kids have craving for butter, cheesy things. They'll always wish to eat those cheese pizzas and cheese-filled pastas. And a very peculiar symptom of pulsatilla is cough with greenish or yellowish, very viscid, thick sputum or a phlegm coming out. And this serves as an excellent remedy for conjunctivitis, especially when the discharge from the eyes is yellowish, bland and thick.
You know one thing, Kavita here, I'd like to add, can you discuss something about pulsatilla? Pulsatilla child, when he or she comes from school, he has had a fight with a natrum baby, and how will the pulsatilla child come home? Not taking exam, huh? This is, you just said it, the pulsatilla will not complain. You just had it, pulsatilla is the yielding types, it's very mild types. Allow the other children to get dominated, dominate her or him. They will never complain to the teacher. They'll probably just come home and cry. Okay? They are the people who get bullied easily. They will never establish the control over people like the other drugs which you saw. They will come home, cry, weep, just go in their shell, go at the side, but they will never complain. They may complain in other form, but they will not retaliate, right?
Then comes our next very peculiar red-nosed borax kid. A peculiar feature of borax is when the nurse tries to put the baby in the cradle, he'll suddenly give a fit of shock. This is very peculiar symptom. They're more prone to aphthae, recurrent aphthae in mouth, and a peculiar sour smelling smell from borax babies. A very short drug, but a beautiful drug, and a child, before he starts urinating, will start screaming. So mother will suddenly realize, that this is the time to pass urine, and he'll start screaming and shrilling very, very loudly. That's a typical borax child. And prone to unhealthy skin, vesicular eruptions, red-filled eruptions, a lot of pustular discharge. Next, we go to our notorious chamomilla.
So, why are you giving me?
You can start.
With a smile that too. I was in chamomilla. So chamomilla is sort of exalted Sina. Okay, again, those touch me not. Fit of anger. Also chokes. becomes red. With so much of crying becomes red on crying. There's a rubric here. Rubric in the sense of symptom becomes red on crying. Chamomilla is extremely hypersensitive baby. He is like Sina, those irritable. But when given what wants, also refuses. He's irritable, fretful, peevish. Anger is the keynote. Anger. But again, you'll say Natramur also has anger. But Natramur anger is deep-seated anger. Kai Maheshya se vaktat kai. Aim Karish is right from the childhood. Chamomilla is anger also goes up and goes down also fast. It's very more of a superficial type of anger. Natramur is the complex mental state in early childhood itself. Okay, chamomilla is one of our also good drugs for dentitional diarrhea, and we use chamomilla also in the elderly people or elderly children like us, where the pain is immense, number one, and the anger and the anxiety is immense. More than anxiety is the anger. Okay, more than anxiety is the anger. Natramur has anxiety, anguish, and the deep-seated feelings. Look at this, quiet only when carried. He keeps on crying. The nice ad which comes of some mobile phone. This small little baby of 1 year is just crying. The aya takes, the mossy takes, the dad takes. Doesn't go to anyone, keeps on crying. But when the mom takes the child sleeps as if, you know, nothing has happened. And then the caption comes. Eh? What the caption comes? The phone where the home territory belongs to. Something of the sort. This for me? Calcarea foss. Another child with calcarea element as well as a foss element. Because of the foss element, these people are tall, thin, scrofulousness, the false element of naughtiness, the false element of being friendly, and the calcarea part also, which means a bit of calcarea features of chilliness also, and the perspiration which is seen on hands, the forehead, and also on the back. Emaciated neck, enlarged heads, dark eyes and hair, and dark complexion. Calcarea foss, like Natramur, also has these children who eat a lot, but yet they remain thin and scrawny. They don't put on weight. Most of the calcarea foss children which you see are very thin, but they are not as weak as the calcarea carb counterparts. Their milestones may be a bit delayed, their dentition is a bit delayed, the fusing of the sutures is a bit delayed. A bit delay in the milestones, but overall calcarea foss babies are the sharp, the witty, the good in studies babies. Okay, wants to go home, but when at home wants to go out, fine, that's okay. And also have the school girls headache or school children's headache, which and also good drug for growing pains. Baraita ka. Okay, this is one of our interesting babies, Baraita Kaab babies. When we were in medical college, Baraita Kaab babies were sort of branded as not so glamorous or not so desirable type of babies. Why? Because, you know, they are a bit delayed in their activities, a bit delayed in their milestones. Their mental faculties also are a bit slow. Because of the calcarea element, they are a bit sluggish with these saturnine influences. They are not those fast babies like the phosphorus or the calcarea foss. They also, Baraita Kaab babies also have certain problems in their dentition, some bones and sutures. They are scared. They have got tremendous type of fears. If someone knocks the door or there's a bell on the door, these babies would just run away and hide behind a sofa or behind a mom and see everything. So much shy. They will not come to you. They will not talk to you. It's not out of, it's out of shyness and fear. Dr. Kavita will talk about shyness of Silesia to more extent, but in Baraita Kaab it's more of fear. You know, sometimes we feel, why this child is not coming to me? Many reasons. Natrum will not come, who are you? Platina baby also will not come to you because that haughtiness, that why, no, I don't want you. Platina babies get attracted also towards glamorous people. Even phosphorus babies, which I'm going to talk later. There are some babies who like, when even in their age of one or two, they see someone very smart, someone good looking, some beautiful lady comes with a lot of good clothes, they'll just go to him or her. That's the phosphorus, palladium, and also the platina babies. The baraita ka babies will not come to you, not out of all these things, but it is basically out of fear, timidity. Are mala ke kela tar? The pulsatilla baby again will go to you, but again is timid. He will not be dominating. He will not tell you, idhar do, ye chahiye, wo chahiye. They'll be happy. They'll smile. They'll enjoy their time in your arms. The baraita kab is hallmark of fear. Slow in grasping. The child grows and the grades fall. The teacher calls up that this boy is not paying attention. What do we do? And there's suddenly an alarm. People come to us, Doctor Sahab, kuch tonic dijiye. Tonic se sab theek ho jayega. But it is not the case. I believe everyone is intelligent in their own way. We should give time. Baraita Kab also is intelligent in their own way. There are a lot of good facets about Baraita Kab. Give them their time, train them well, okay, and our medicine support. They'll help to get this child out of these problems. Okay, they are easily tired because of the carbonium element. Easily tired, so give them good nourishment. Okay, don't scold them. Give them their time, they will open out. Okay, give them their time, they'll open out. As I said, baraita carb. Carb means scrofulousness, means the enlargement of glands. Baraita carb child many times has a mouth open. And we call them as idiots. It is not so. It is because the nose is blocked. The tonsils are swollen. The child has to breathe through the mouth. So such children are misinterpreted as dumb. And we brand them, hey, duffar hai. It should not be done. Nowadays, I feel, Kavita, nowadays schools, the times have changed now. In my times or in your times, we still had this categorization. A, B, C, D. D matlab ekdam ye. Ye duffar hai. Duffar ek bar stamp lag gaya, fir all the 10 years duffar. Or A grade matlab all the grade A grade. So that is thankfully not done nowadays, you know. Nowadays, schools awareness has increased, as sir said correctly. And what has happened now is that every child is intelligent in his or own way. Okay, intelligence is not one is book intelligent, one is language intelligence, one is intelligence with math, one is intelligence with music, one with vocation, one with physical training. So every child is important, every child is intelligent in their own way. So dribbling salivation and weak digestion, baraita kab, very interesting drug, and with these medications we can tackle all these states. A very, very interesting drug, Kavita, over to you. Silesia.
So now here comes the stubborn silesia. I would call it as a smart silesia kid, because these children, if you see, they are very quiet, very timid. You go to any social function, you know, they will pretend that, you know, they will sit very neatly. No masti, no mischievousness. But when they go home, they're a different picture. So they're image conscious, you see. They are image conscious. They want to keep, they want to be the best in the public. They want to portray themselves as that hum ekdam chup chap aur achhe bache hain. But at home, their nature is completely opposite. The second important point about silesia children I would like to put forth is they are perfectionist, sir. They are perfectionist. They don't want to ever get hurt, but they are very smart because they know their deficiencies. Mujhe ye khamiya hai, but they will work towards it. Hard working is a trait of a silesia child. A perfectionist, mothers will come up to us and say that mera bachcha aisa hai ki wo timetable banayega. 6:30 he will get up. 6:35 is brushing the teeth. 6:40 is going to the toilet. 6:45 is being ready. And such a perfectionist that he will say that today I'm going to wear this, I'm going to wear this, I'll wear these socks, I'll wear these shoes. That is a perfectionist silesia. And they get dressed very neatly because of their image consciousness. Very hard working, perform superb, and will always take part in competitions, you know, be it a drawing competition or a handwriting competition. They know that they're not going to win, but still they put their efforts and work hard towards it. That is a stubborn and a smart Silesia kid. We see this young girl over here, a young kid, very delicate, a lean constitution and extremely chilly thermally. Like Calcarea group, even Silesia has a tendency towards constipation. They are chronically constipated. They have lack of vital heat. So they have a tendency to catch cold easily. These kids will come with allergic rhinitis, inflammation of the sinuses. They have chronic nose blockage or a stuffed nose, middle ear infections, which are quite recurrent. This is the best suppuration remedy in our homeopathic materia medica. Especially what we see in kids' age group also with abscesses, sinusitis, allergic rhinitis. They are prone to caries of teeth.
Lack of vital heat means what?
The body doesn't react to the stimulus well, so they are prone to infections. The weakness, what we say, no, I'm not feeling good. I don't have that energy in me. That's lack of vital heat. As I already told you all, it's a wonderful drug for suppurative processes. This is a Silesia baby. And now we come with our fascinating phosphorus baby.
With you. Let's start.
Silesia kids, yes, they are very smart. As I told you, they're image conscious. If you are there, if you go in a social function, they'll be sitting quietly at a place. So they know when to react, how to react. That way they are very sharp and very intelligent.
Let me add here, if you read Vitulkas's Elements of Homeopathy, he talks about Silesia as those extremely polished, extremely witty, extremely bureaucratic type of people. You've seen bureaucrats? You know, I've seen a lot of IS. I don't like to use these words. So everyone is cunning nowadays. Everybody is cunning. So let's not use the word. So, you know, you see these bureaucrats. These top IS and IPS officers, you know, the way they walk, they are very polished. They are very, the words they use are very choosy. It doesn't mean they are diplomatic, but they are trained in such a way. The aristocracy, Vitulkas has used the word aristocratic for Silesia. Even if they don't like something, they will not be like these Sina or these Natrams, where they will react this way that you get lost. But the answer will be given to you in a very nice way. Okay, they'll cut you off. They'll neglect you. They'll not look at you. Or they'll smile and then move away gracefully. So even you're not hurt and he gets his stuff done. You know, so the Silesias grow up to be a very aristocratic, classy people. Phosphorus, all yours. I'll add later.
Phosphorus. A magnetic personality, you always get attracted to a phosphorus child. Very beautiful, blue eyes, same like a pulsatilla kid, a fine skin, a fair skin. The look of the baby will attract you. And as I said, like we hug the calcarea babies, same your phosphorus, you actually go and want to kiss them, you know, sir. Said they're so beautiful, so bubbling and so inviting nature, as I told you. Just go and hug them, cuddle with them, play around with them. That's a phosphorus personality. They're always smiling. They have no grudges against anyone. Always bubbly, but they are delicate at the same time. We'll speak about the phosphorus mind, sir.
Yeah. Let's keep the same slide. You know, I want them to see this slide and the previous one as well. So, as Dr. Kavita said, these are the people, these are the children who right from their childhood have no ill against you. They'll go to you. They will take you as a good person. Okay? When it comes about sharing, phosphorus children will be the first people to share their toys to everyone. Tu ghena. Why don't you take it? You take it. They'll be the first people to give everything to you. They are givers. Now, causticum also is a child. My friend Rachna told me that causticum is also a child who is also, sorry, causticum is comes very close to phosphorus. Because in the term benevolent, phosphorus and causticum come together. Causticum baby will weep for you if the other child is weeping. Sometimes, you know, you see in a playgroup, ek bachcha rone lag gaya,
और दो तीन रोने लग जाते हैं. और जो रोते हैं वो द सेंसिटिव पीपल, दीज आर द फॉस्फरस एंड द कॉस्टिकम. अ नेट्रम विल नॉट क्राई, नेट्रम विल गो इन सम अदर कॉर्नर. मेरे को डिस्टर्ब क्यों किया, मेरे को डिस्टर्ब क्यों किया. फॉस्फरस बेबी विल गो अप टू यू एंड यू नो शेयर, तूने खाना खाया, तू लेना ये. सो ऑल दो स्वीट लिटिल चिल्ड्रन विच वी सी इन द मूवीज आर ऑल फॉस्फरस पर्सनैलिटीज. वेदर इज गुड एंड बैड आई डू नॉट नो, नथिंग इज गुड नथिंग इज बैड, इट्स अ पर्सनैलिटी. ओके, एवरीथिंग आर गॉड्स क्रिएशंस. वी आर नो वन टू टॉक अबाउट गुड एंड बैड, वी आर नॉट हियर टू मेक एनी वैल्यू बेस्ड जजमेंट्स, दिस इज द पर्सनैलिटी. ओके, वेल लेट अस सी वॉट इज रिटन हियर. फुल ऑफ एंथुजियाज्म एक्साइटमेंट, यू कॉल देम एनी टाइम, दे विल कम, दे लाइक टू ट्रैवल. वेल ऑल चिल्ड्रन एंजॉय ट्रैवलिंग. You know, if you want to have any child come with you, usko gaadi ka chabi batane ka ya cycle ka, chalo ghumane le ja rahe hain. Okay, inquisitive, these are the first engineers. You leave your radio, aaj ka radio nahi hota, you leave your mobile or something which is openable with them and go out. Well, you will have them in 3 or 4 pieces because they'll be the people who opening everything. Andar kya hai, curiosity. Okay, they are excellent imaginations. So the phosphorus is a very intelligent baby in terms of intelligence, bookish intelligence, as well as explorative, as well as music type of endeavors also. Next please. Fair transparent skin, delicate eyelashes, chilly patient, this is we've seen in the first slide itself of phosphorus. Love for animals. I remember this movie whenever I think about phosphorus, baby's day out, you see that baby, okay, and he calls that magazine in which he sees everything as boo boo. In the entire movie he is shown just smiling. Those 4 funny villains, they are cute actually, they are very cute, those no crying at all with strangers. Okay, so this is what the whole phosphorus baby is all about. They go close to a dog, they will go close to this cute Brandy, the dog's name is Brandy, they'll go close to him, hug him, and we get scared. Are baba kutra hai to motha hai tani ke killer tar. But friends, dogs kuch nahi karte, they are very close. In fact, dogs are the most sensitive people. They are very very gentle with all these kids. Anything more about phosphorus, Ashna?
These kids, phosphorus, if you see a characteristic is they'll always crave those icy cold things. You offer them a candy or you offer them an ice cream, there'll be people who lovingly take it, grab it from your hand. That intense craving they have for icy cold things. As we say, a very pleasing personality of phosphorus child. He, same like Silesia, he is a perfectionist. He or she is a perfectionist because they unconsciously have that fear of being punished. They don't want to be punished in the school. So they are neat, very clear with their views, very clear with their thoughts, and always hardworking. So these are all your children remedies here. Hope you all liked it. Thank you so much and wish you all a very wonderful evening. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Acha, mind blowing as you become up to adult, apart from addition, deletion due to growing and obviously the main characteristic remains same.
Well, we are online. Well, a very interesting question. What just for our viewers here, what sir is asking is that does the constitution remain the same? You'll answer it? I'll answer it. The thing is that as far as I have known, people don't change. Okay, people don't change. You have come with certain traits, those remain. They can be modified to certain extent. Okay, I'm seeing my school friends, some friends who are really arrogant, they are still arrogant. Okay, my school friends, some of them who are like really nice, going out of the way, are still the same. Well, you can modify to certain extent, but basic traits do remain same unless you know someone is really enlightened or someone has some instances in life whereby he gets a shock and then realizes ki I need to change now.
Some paradigm shift may be there.
Some paradigm shift, as sir said, is possible, but these are only if there are certain instances and as an introspection happening. Okay, so basic nature does not change.
Definitely I'll put one point is the maturity. As a baby, grows or transforms into a child and then into adult, the maturity level, the thought process definitely changes, but the body constitution, what we see, is throughout the same. And as sir said, there are traits, certain traits which remain throughout. If I am a pleasing personality, I will remain. If there is a child who is very stubborn, he will. The maturity level will definitely get his stubbornness down over a period of time, but not completely change him. So I hope your doubt is solved.
Conclude, na? Conclude.
You find in the whole talk, types, the remedies have never been discussed.
Well, now these types are the remedies itself. So this is phosphorus is a remedy. The calcarea carb is a remedy, the borax is a remedy. So all these are medications, and we prescribe them in the children who have got certain physical or certain mental symptoms which are coming up, which are extraordinary and which are out of proportion. So with these medications, we can help the baby to tackle these small niggling problems. But these personality types help us to come towards the remedy. So when I come to know it's a child who is very stubborn, very obstinate, not listening to the parents, crying, you know, having his or her way done, then I think a natremur types hai. So probably my mental faculties take me the natremur may be helpful to him. And then on further inspection, if the natremur symptoms, physical symptoms fall in the child, then the natremur drug will be given. So we don't make prescriptions only on mentals or only on physicals. It has to be a combination, you see, of the physical and mental symptoms and the characteristic symptoms together.
The children types and the remedies go very parallel. In an office, if we see live patients, all these drugs will help to differentiate between two kids. That is a relation between a child or a child type and a remedy. So if you see, we differentiate between two patients or two remedies in a kid.
True. Absolutely. Now yesterday in one of my epilepsy OPDs, I think I did mention to you, it was a great achievement for us. Epileptic boy with four drugs going on, and whole night this movement keeps on. Whole night this movement of hand. So basically he or she has this epileptic tendency along with some movement disorder. And four allopathic drugs are not able to control that. Normally one or two drugs must be able to tackle it. So I was called, I took the detailed case. He fitted in something called as tarantula, which again Dr. Shah will tell you is restless. Tarantula spider, you know, restless, along with certain traits which are like liking music, okay, very sensitive, and his movement disorder. We gave tarantula 201 dose, and even our boss was very happy. He said, "Key, this has stopped. The movement has stopped."
Involuntary,
because tarantula was the constitutional medicine. Does it mean that tarantula is going to change the nature of the boy? The answer is no, but it can definitely modify to a certain extent that it will not be creating a problem. Chamomilla babies can't be changed, but with chamomilla we have seen so many children becoming much more calmer. We get a call at night, "Doctor Saab, at least now wo kam chilla rahi hai."
Na shanti se so raha hai ab mera bachcha. This is what the parents tell us.
I think it was wonderful to discuss these drugs, and wonderful to have such a nice audience here. So we'll come again with a lot of more such discussions. Kavita?
Thank you so much, everyone. Have a wonderful evening. Thank you.